What's going on, guys? Aiden here, and today I am relaunching my YouTube channel. It's 2022. That was going to be one of my resolutions, and today we are going to fulfill it. If you don't know who I am, my name is Aiden. I'm a 24-year-old trans man from Kansas City, and I decided to relaunch my YouTube channel because I feel like I can kind of relate to a lot of the trans youth on YouTube and help answer some questions. With that being said, in today's video, I'm going to talk about the 5 things I wish I would have known before starting testosterone. So first and foremost, I wish that I would have known how long it was actually going to take to start medically transitioning. Just to kind of put that into perspective, I am 24 years old now. It took me 2 years to actually start medically transitioning. First of all, it's really hard to find a therapist right now. Second of all, you have to be going to that therapist for an entire year before you're able to actually get that letter of recommendation to actually start your medical transition. And then you have to take that to an endocrinologist. The endocrinologist has to say, okay, you get your health tested, and then your primary care doctor writes off on that, and then you can get your prescription for testosterone. So it's not just some easy walk in the park, like, hey, I'm gonna go get testosterone today, I've decided, and then you go in and you get it written. Like, that's usually not how that goes. So the second thing that I wish I would have known are the physical changes that I wasn't really prepared for before starting testosterone, because sometimes that can be a make it or break it deal. You know, your face is gonna widen, so your bone structure is not going to be the same if you take, if you stop taking testosterone. It will stay, you know, very masculinized. I have a really big nose now compared to then, my jaw widened. Your fat redistributes. So if you have a lot of like curve in your hips, then that's going to redistribute straight to your stomach. So you're going to have more of like a gut rather than hips, which is nice for some guys. If you want that triangular look, you can kind of achieve it through that. The other thing is body hair. You get really thick leg hair, really thick armpit hair. You get hair on your back, your stomach, your chest, the whole 9 yards, okay? It's everywhere, everywhere. Listen, I'm talking like it's gonna come in on your hands and your toes and your before it comes in on your face, okay? Be prepared for that, because, you know, I know you want that beard, but you gotta endure all this first. The third thing I wish someone would have told me was how horrible acne hurts, okay? So 9 times out of 10, if you're going through puberty, you're gonna get some acne, unless you've got flawless skin, which my first puberty that I had no acne. So I thought, oh, this is gonna be a breeze, it's gonna be a walk in the park. Absolutely not. Absolutely not. I had acne all over my face, all over my back and my butt. There's acne on my chest, my shoulders. It horrible. Horrible acne, and it hurts. You know, I was super thankful that we started quarantine whenever that stuff hit, because I didn't want to go out of my house. I was like embarrassed, I was scared. I know that sounds crazy, but I was super self-conscious about it, and it hit around the 5-6 month mark on testosterone, and it just cleared up. I'm 2 years now, probably around the two year mark, honestly. So I had it for like a good year and a half-ish, that it was just awful, horrible. And nothing would clear it up but time. Literally like nothing would clear it up. I went to a dermatologist, they were gonna prescribe me Accutane. I was taking some pill that I can't even remember, and it kinda helped, but it didn't. I'm on benzoyl peroxide, face wash, back wash, body wash, the whole thing, and nothing was helping. So yeah, I was not prepared for that. All right, you guys, so for tip number 4, I'm gonna talk about getting a hysterectomy, okay? So I wish I had known that after around the 5-year mark on T, you've got to wind up getting a hysterectomy, because testosterone does in fact kill your whole uterus. It's just basically a dead organ floating inside your body, and it makes you really sick. Gives you really bad cramps, and you have to get it taken out. Again, I'm only 2 years on testosterone, so that hasn't had to happen to me. A lot of my trans friends do have their hysterectomies already, and it was a fine procedure. But for someone who, you know, still wants to save their eggs, still wants to have kids, like freeze them later down the line, you might want to talk to your endocrinologist about maybe your fertility options in the future before you start testosterone, to maybe get the best results on having a child in the future that's biologically yours, if that's something that you're into. If not, just, you know, prepare for the fact that you will 99% chance have to have a hysterectomy in the future. All right, so my last and my final tip isn't really a tip that I wish someone would have told me. It's more of something that I wish everybody was more comfortable talking about, and that is, how long should you stay on testosterone? Honestly, it's up to you. Most trans men, they can stay on testosterone if they want to keep seeing the changes. They stay on testosterone for forever. But you don't have to do that. If you feel more comfortable with the changes you've seen in 5 months and you want to stop, some of the changes will revert a little bit, but that's okay. You can always get right back on testosterone. It is your body. You know, just make sure everything you do is through your doctor first. Get your levels drawn regularly, everything like that. It's your body. Stop taking it whenever you want. You don't even have to tell anybody. There's plenty of trans men out there who stop and get back on it later in life if they want to see some more changes. So, all right, you guys, so that is it for this video. So make sure you hit that like and subscribe button, and I will catch you next week on another video. See ya.